The Moon and Me, August 2020. Shaken awake by restless third eye, third war visions mistaken for a midnight earthquake. I step outside under the lonely LA moon and marvel at the mystery of being alive, of being myself, of being anything at all. How's the weather up there? I sarcastically ask the moon. As above, so below, she casually replies. It's August and I don't know what's happening. I haven't seen my friends in months. My unkempt beard is starting to resemble a bird's nest, and I'm wearing Tibetan prayer beads around my neck for no apparent reason. I must look like either a lunatic or sage. Meanwhile, the whole world is stuck somewhere between a global pandemic, an authoritative power grab, an economic meltdown, an environmental crisis, and a spiritual awakening. Everything feels so heavy, I tell the moon. Have you tried letting go? She replies. The sky above Venice Boardwalk is, like 2020 itself, a Rorschach test or psychedelic journey. You'll see whatever your subconscious mind is preconditioned to perceive. As for me, behind the clouds, my mind connects the constellation dots to form visions of apocalyptic horsemen disguised as international bankers and tech CEOs. YouTube revelations of deep state prostate cancer rattle around my head like catchy one-hit wonders I can't forget. I want to turn the music off. I don't want to be complicit in anyone's ancient prophecy. I stand alone at the western edge of the world and recite white magic mantras into the silent ether to counterbalance the argumentative absolute opinions reigning like a nuclear antichrist in the atmosphere of mind. And as the ocean tides begin to turn, I realize that Terence McKenna was right. The universe is not constructed with the hardware of atoms and protons and bricks and bombs. It is programmed with the deeply seated, subtle software of language and imagination. The sharp constricting lines mistaken for our own limitations are merely the illusion of linguistic corners the lawyers have painted us into. The haunted airwaves broadcast 3D, 5G, mind virus, nonlinear warfare indoctrination into our brains to scramble the signal of community fellowship. Black against white, man against woman, left against right, until we're united only by our shared confusion and outrage. God be with us. Ram Dass is dead, and I'd rather be anywhere than here now. The universe seems to be spinning towards some morbidly poetic grand finale, or perhaps a dramatic crescendo before the next Aquarian chapter begins. And in the distance, planets dance while laughing at inside jokes I don't understand. It sometimes feels, I tell the moon, that we're all being sucked, slowly and unavoidably, into a bottomless black hole. We are, she says, but wow, what a view.